a different book.
Well,
a different
book idea.
I was kind of getting something to worry about you, Dick.
Yeah.
I was kind of something to worry about you.
Put that down. Oh, they put one out here. Never mind, Glenn. Right here.
Put him in this box. Just leave him right here.
Leave him right there.
This goes down through there somewhere?
No, put this. Goes in here.
Someone on this team.
I believe I did that. I kept thinking this is Friday.
This was a Sunday one. This will be Monday.
I guess so. I have a clue what day it is. I've been off for 2 weeks, so I'm screwed up.
I've been going for almost 4 weeks now.
Can't believe I did that. I've been looking forward to this game too. Hey, we're ready. Jane, we're ready. It's rock and roll. What? Did Eric call? Okay. All right. We can go, you want to fade it and go, you can do that.
I think it was like
Hey, I made it. I won't tell you what happened, but I made it. We'll be ready in a minute. I'll tell you when. Hey, if we need to get Steph on here. Check 3-1-2. Check.
I have no idea what is going on. We do not have an announcer.
You got starters yet, Carmen?
I do.
Woo! I wonder if I remember how to do this, Steph.
Get that thing fixed.
Check that out. What?
Get that thing fixed.
We're good. Well, good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Dennis Slash Sports Arena on the campus of Pratt Community College. And we really get things cranked up now with conference season here. Stephanie Thompson, the head coach of the Beavers, joins us here on the program on the pregame show brought to you by Doug Gray Chevrolet. Well, Steph, we had a little bit of time off, a whole lot of time off, and then you got to start with a tough team in Hutchinson, as always. They are tough. All right, Steph, you had a pretty good outing the last outing, but you didn't really come out a winner. But boy, what a big feather this would be today if you could just pull this one off here at home. All right, Steph, hey, we'll talk to you later. Thanks. That's Stephanie Thompson, the head coach of the Beavers, here this afternoon, getting ready to go. And it is conference time here on the KMMM Sports Network. 22 nights of basketball coming up in January, folks. So get ready, because it's going to be one of those kind of years that's just going to really start off hectic. Glenn Cunningham joins me on the broadcast here today. Glenn, this team averages 84 points. I'm talking about Hutch. They're 13-1. They average 84 points a ball game. They shoot 47% from the field. John Anches has been there 9 years, national champ last year, but had a little misfortune and got stripped of that title. But, wow, this club's good, and the Beavers are really going to play well. Take the blue ones. Take
okay.
the blue ones.
Okay.
And then put the red back there.
Okay.
Hey. Hey.
Give 5 up
to the
starting
line.
Place, I guess.
Okay.
Yeah, John is just one of those guys that's, you watched him. We watched him play in high school, and then he went on and played in college. He's an awful good basketball coach. But you know what? There's a pretty good basketball coach on the other side, too.
Yeah.
Get there.
She's got a club that's not bad either. I find my women's stats here real quick. I'm kind of discombobulated. Forgot what day it was.
Well, yeah. I thought it was Sunday.
Yeah. It's game day, man. I'm telling you. The Beavers average 61 points a ball game. They shoot 40% from the field. They shoot 21% from three-point range. They average 14 assists a ball game. Of course, it all starts through... Excuse me, through the little guard Jasmine Ortiz out of Temple, Texas. We'll just have to see how much this layoff did to both these teams as far as their shooting percentages and stuff are concerned. But that's, you know, again, one of those teams that, man, you would like to have a game in between this one, I would think. But, hey, you got to play. Stephanie's team's 8-5 on the year. They lost at Seward County just before Christmas break. A tough loss out there, but Seward's always good. Man, they had it. They got some three-point shooters out there. I want to say they just rained threes on Stephanie and her gang when we were out there. So, see if the Beavers can hang on to things and pull one out here today at the opening up of conference season here in Pratt, and then everything kicks off. And as I said before, next week the high school basketball season gets started again. But we're ready to go. Glenn's ready to go. I guess I'm ready to go. If I can remember what day it is, we'll be fine. Georgia Butente is out of Croatia. She is 5'6". Mandy Madden, 6'1", sophomore from Topeka. Taylor Staley is a 5'8", freshman from Newton. And Kylie Robert Rogers is a 6-foot freshman. She is from Wichita, Kansas. For your Pratt Community College Beavers this afternoon, they start like this. Jasmine Ortiz, a 5'6 sophomore out of Temple, Texas. Aubrey Noose is a 5'9 sophomore from Sterling. And we're going to interrupt this just for a minute because the national anthem is about to be sung, and we'll get back to the starting lineup in a minute.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
national anthem, some by, I guess one of the guys that packed him. I guess I did not get his name. I'm sorry. Let's start right all over again for the Stephanie Thompson's Pratt Community College Beavers. Jasmine Ortiz, a 5'6 sophomore out of Temple, Texas. Aubrey Noose is a 5'9 sophomore from Sterling, Kansas. Lexi Schumberger is a 5'9 freshman from Hoxie, Kansas. Graham Baxter is a 6-foot freshman from Kearns, Texas. And Tanisha Rohde is a 5'10 sophomore, and she is from Fort Worth, Texas. So that's your starting lineups for both teams. Starting lineups are brought to you by Car Wash 54 and Pratt. Pick your side of your ride, get it all tuned up and ready to go. And we're getting ready for some Pratt Community College basketball here on the KMM Sports Network. Glad to have you along with us as we get started into the conference season. A busy month coming up, Glenn. 22 nights of basketball. Are you ready for this? I don't know if I am. I counted right, buddy. It is tournament time as well.
And that
is one of the things that we look forward to, of course, going to the St. John tournament later on with the high school, and then of course the tournament of champions Tuesday night. We're going to kick off with the Pratt High School Greenbacks as they get into their conference season. Hoisington will be at Pratt High School, and we are about ready to go here. Yeah, Dennis Les Sports Arena. Glad to have you along with us here on day after New Year's. Hope your New Year's celebration and Christmas was safe. Safe, happy one for you. Now, each team getting their instructions from the bench as we get ready to go here. Again, today, Hutchison, the visitors, dressed in their all red with dark blue numbers. The Beavers in their white uniforms with blue numbers, and Granite Baxter will jump it up for the Beavers against Rogers, a 6-foot freshman out of Wichita. Brianna, they got her listed at 5'8 or 5'9, and I think he's a little taller than that. All right, here we go. Jasmine Ortiz with the first possession. Comes Alexi Schomburger on the near side to the top of the key. Rohde drives the basket and hits off the side of the basket. It's rebounded underneath there by Madden. Hutch on the attack. He'll bring it down top of the key to Madden. He'll dump it down inside, and there's Rogers for the bucket on a backdoor cut that nobody picked her up. 2-0, Hutch, long pass for Aubrey Noose on the near side wing for the Beavers. Bell Rohde on the far side. Rohde looked like she was going to hand it off, did not. Now slaps it back outside to Baxter. Noose to the far side wing at the elbow. Now comes to the top of the key with Baxter. Baxter down to the baseline. Drops it down inside. Turnaround shot by Rohde. No good. Baxter with a rebound. She got knocked out of bounds, and they say it's off Baxter. Looked like a little reach over underneath there, but no call made. She could have got with those long arms, knocked it away and not touched her. They'll bring it up. Buta brings it up. They go to the far side to Rogers. Now pass it around the perimeter, near side to Buta. On the top of the key, three-point shot in and out. No good. Rohde with the rebound. Hands it off to Ortiz. Pratt on the attack. Into the front court. They'll come to the near side elbow to Schomburger. Lexi to the top of the key. Now back far side to Rogers. Rogers on the far side wing to Ortiz. Now back to Baxter on the near side, and now they throw it out of bounds. Started to go to the baseline and threw it over the top of Noose. She was cutting to the baseline but just missed her. 2-0, Hutch leads. We're just underway in the first quarter of play. The ladies play four quarters. The guy plays two halves. Talk about getting me all messed up. Rogers to the far side, and there's a turnover for Hutch. That pass too high. Jasmine Ortiz wide open is Noose, and she gets the bucket. Aubrey Noose with the bucket. Out to the far side they'll go. This is Buta. Now a call underneath, and I believe that's going to be on Rohde for pushing off. We'll see. Got the elbow out, I guess. So first one on Rohde, and here comes Maddie Ducey. Maddie, 5'10", sophomore out of Phillipsburg. Her first appearance here in this ball game. They bring it back to the near side to Pressner. Now they'll dump it down inside to Madden. They'll pass it around the perimeter. Buta down inside she goes, and she's going to get called. Or no, they're going to call the blocking foul on. My goodness. That was just a little old touch foul there. Hutch has the ball underneath their own basket. Inbounded, and it won't go in. And Schomburger with the rebound. They'll pick it up. Ortiz down the far side to Noose. Aubrey down, dumps it underneath to Maddie. Maddie gets the ball blocked out of bounds. Mandy Madden underneath there, 6'1 sophomore. Now into the ball game becomes Carla Williams. Williams, a 5'10 freshman from New Orleans. And we got a flat basketball. Cold one. Yeah. Slippery. They get cold, they get slippery, they get real hard too as well. So they're going to have John Hutch check it. And he just looked at it and threw it back to us. Hey, if it's good for you guys, it's good for me. Inbounded, Aubrey Noose for the Beavers underneath their own basket. 2-2 tie, and Rohde gives it back out to Noose. Now back to Ortiz on the far side elbow. Top of the key to Lexi Schomburger, near side to Dusen. Back out front to Schomburger. Schomburger going to the far side. You got 8 on the shot clock, and there's a foul. Two of them going toward it, and Buta is going to get called for the foul. Her first team foul on Hutchison. Blue Dragons, only one loss on the season so far. Far side to Schomburger. Now they'll give it to Rohde on the near side wing, and Now, and again, Hutch steals the basketball and on fast break, and that is a charging foul. Lexi Schomburger takes the charge. She'd been standing there for an hour and got run over by Staley.
Good job, Lex.
If you're not familiar why that half moon there is there in college, anything inside that is fair game. You can get after it inside that circle, but if you're outside that circle that's and foul somebody, that's you'll get called for. Again, ball knocked out of bounds. They're trying to attack it inside, and big 6'1 gal Madden knocks it out of bounds. Rohde off the glass, won't go. It's knocked away, picked up there by Williams. Williams hands it off to Butina. There's a three-point shot, no good. And again, Madden with the rebound, but Rohde fighting with her, and there. Out of bounds, it goes to Beavers. Megan Poole comes in the ball game. Megan, a 6'2 freshman. She is from Council Grove High School, but she's out Alta Vista, Kansas, which I believe is about the size of 400 people, if I remember right. Schomburger near side. Now they're going to go over the top to Megan Poole, and Poole gets the little jump shot. Good. Megan Poole is really good when she gets within 10 foot. 4-2, Beavers lead. Bertina comes in the near side. Staley back out front to Williams. Williams to the far side to Rogers. Now they'll bring it back to the near side. And now foul's going to get called underneath, banging around going on underneath there.
Wait, 32.
And that one is on Maddie Deucing.
32.
Her first, team's third foul. They get five per quarter, and then they shoot two. Another rule change this year in the Jayhawk Conference. Come to the near side, there's a three-point shot, no good. And it's a foul called underneath that did not count. The three-pointer didn't count. Yep. And Williams gets called for that one. So now that's the second foul on Hutch. Pratt on top here, 4-2. We're about 2 minutes. We're a little more than that, 4 minutes into this one. The 10-minute quarters. And Patty Deucen down to the baseline. Schomburger, far side, the noose back underneath the Schomburger. She tries to get it over the top. Poole gets the rebound, but he has the ball knocked away when she bumped back up with it. Short jump shot, no good. Poole with the rebound. So the Beavers on the run. Schomburger back out front to Ortiz. Now to Deucen. Down the far side they go to Neus. They'll bring it back out front. Deucen will come to the near side wing. Back out front to Neus. Now back. Maddie's going to drive it. Underneath she goes, shoots it over the top of the basket, and a whistle and timeout is called. 30-second timeout on the floor. Hutch takes it. Pratt's ahead 4-2. We'll be back in 30 seconds. You're listening to Beaver Basketball. Whew.
Break time.
Huh?
Break time.
Yeah. They don't look near as good as they've been in the past. Hutch doesn't look near as good as they've been in the past. Well, welcome back to Beaver Basketball. Beavers lead 4-2 here. 5:14 left in the first quarter of play. Now there's some discussion. Yeah, and not quite sure what the discussion is.
It should be on 20.
Okay.
Let's fix that.
All right, we'll fix that. You got it. Thank you. That's all we need. Confirmation. Good. All right, okay. Here we go. Focus on 20.
Shot clock's on 20.
The player control.
The moving screen?
No.
Oh, the charge.
Yeah. Okay, there we go. Stefan wanted a clarification as well. John Hutch is standing almost 4 feet out on the court down on the other end. Inside they go. And Rogers with it. Hutch with the basketball. Blue Dragons. Bertina drives it to the paint. Won't go on. Hits the bottom of the rim. Megan Poole has the ball slapped away. And Hutch has it back. Ooh. Almost a little contact and a little travel, but nothing called. Bertina to the near side to Rogers. Rogers can't get a shot off there. Now Bertina dumps it off and a foul's called. The penetration hit and Aubrey News had to catch up and got called for the foul. That's the fourth team foul on the Beavers. To the line goes Carla Williams. From Hutchinson, or she is from, actually she's from New Orleans, Louisiana. She makes the first one. Williams, 69% foul shooter, 4-3 Beavers lead. And she's got to make both of them. Now back in the ball game comes Mandy Madden. Pratt with the basketball. Ortiz has it. She'll bring it up the court. Right down the middle of the court, or else a Beaver face. Now comes the near side to Deuce. Maddie, handoff to Ortiz. Kicks it back to the baseline, and Hodenscheid will come into the ball. And the basket's going to count, and a blocking foul. Bertina got all the way to the basket. Nobody stepped in front of her, and when they did, it was in trouble, and Deuce is going to pick up her second foul. Bertina with the bucket and one here. Hutch leads 6-4, and there's Penicillin coming into the ball game now for the Beavers, as well as Delgamo is a 5'4 freshman. She's right out of Hutch. So now 7-4 lead for the Blue Dragons. Near side to Megan Poole, hands it off to Ortiz. Down inside they go to Poole. She got a little push, but she got the bucket to go. So Megan with another nice bucket there, and it's a 1-point lead for the Blue Dragons, 7-6. Bertina comes in her side. Now back out front it comes to Zarmo. Back to the far side, and Selling's going to get on the arm as Madden goes to the basket. She'll shoot two. Tina, out of Wichita, sophomore, 5'9". Madden, 6'1". Slapped her on the arm, so we'll see if she can make two of these, and she makes the first one. Madden, a 63% foul shooter on the year, and then she misses that one. Averages 11 points a ball game. Ortiz hands it off to Noose. Noose on the far side brings it back to the near side. Poole with the jump shot rolls in. Megan Poole got her shot going right now, and it's tied up at 8. Bertina near side, and she has the ball back. Now she drops it down inside to Rogers, and Rogers knocks it out of bounds, and it goes over to the Beavers. Except for a couple little lapses, defense pretty good against Hutch, Glenn, and it's nice to see that. Underneath, they try to go underneath and they throw it out of bounds. They double team pull that time, and Dominic Brodus comes to the ball game. Brodus, 6'2", sophomore out of St. Louis, Missouri. On the far side, they go to Madden. Now they kick it back out front. Stakely drops dumped it down inside to Rogers. Rogers tries to get it up and under and won't get it, but she's going to get her own rebound and get fouled. Rogers is tough underneath the board. They got to block her out. And that one is going to be on Sellings, and that's her second one. And here comes Brianna Baxter back. Young lady out of Kearns, Texas. That is something good. 9-8 lead for Hutch. Rogers with three here in this first quarter. Winds her up and makes it. Long pass by Ortiz. Pratt trying to run the ball a little bit against his team. Notice Dominic down inside. Can't get anything going there and tried to throw it back out. And Bettina with the basketball with a short jump shot goes in. She makes this club go, the little gal out of Croatia. That was a reach in, but no call made there. Bettina, or excuse me, Ortiz goes inside and gets knocked to the floor. No call made there. A lot of contact. Bettina on the run, and she's going to get fouled. Baxter is going to end up fouling her. She'll go to the line to shoot two more. Boy, a lot of contact. Nothing called on the other end. Hutch gets out running. Beavers can't get back in time. 1:55 left in the quarter, and Stephanie's going to call a 30-second timeout. 12-8, Hutch leads. We'll be back in 30 seconds. You're listening to Beaver Basketball. Well, welcome back to Beaver Basketball from Dennis Les Sports Arena on the campus at Pratt Community College. Our first one of the new year, 2016. And a shot up by Buchanan's good. Averaging 8 points a ball game. 84% foul shooter, so she made both of them. 14-8, so the Beavers got an answer with a bucket here. Back out front they go. Now to Baxter. Baxter goes to the far side, gives it to Noose. Now to the near side to Ortiz. Wide open is Broadus, and Broadus got it. Wide open. Made a nice move underneath, and the Beavers now down by four. 1:31, and there again, Broadus gets the basket. Man, she made a fake one way, and Ortiz took the fake, and she headed to the basket, and she's going to get fouled. And that one's going to be on Hodenscheid. Jada Jones comes in the ball game for the Beavers. And the three-point play is completed. 8-9 points for her out of the 17. Jones to Ortiz. Jada comes, or excuse me, Jasmine comes to the top of the key. Ortiz goes down inside to Broadus. And again, Dominic with a great move. Boy, she got that little spin move down. Last 4 points scored by Dominic Broadus inside the paint. 5-point lead for the Blue Dragons. Beavers. The Blue Dragons with the basketball. Broadus just took that ball away from him, and then Bettina's going to be called for a foul. That's her second. Hutch crowd behind us doesn't like it. That's too bad, ugly. That was a definite foul. Fourth team foul. Pratt has five. 5-point ball game. Under a minute left in the first quarter. Schomburger. Far side to Baxter. Baxter looking underneath. Nothing there. Schomburger looking underneath. Still nothing there. Now Broaddus has got it. Here's Anshie going to do it. Oh, didn't move that time. And going to get called for traveling. A little bit of icky shuffle there. Yep. 29 on the shot clock, 31 on the game clock. The last 30 seconds of this first quarter. Stately down the far side. Williams gets it underneath. Tries to beat Broaddus off the dribble, and she did it. Williams gets that bucket. Jada Jones and inside the paint, foul call. Oh, John Hodges is on that referee, and we couldn't tell whether there was a lot of body contact, but Jada Jones is going to the line to shoot two here with 8 seconds left. Yeah. Jones missed the first one. Jada, sophomore. Out of Fort Worth, I believe, if I remember right. No, St. Paul, Minnesota. He's going to be ready to have a little trouble getting back. Her and Broaddus, a couple days longer, there's a three-point shot at the buzzer, which is no good. So at the end of the first quarter, 19-13, Hutch leads. We'll take a one-minute timeout. We'll be back. More Beaver basketball coming up on the Mighty 1290 KMM Radio.
Tonight's game night sponsor is Simply Southwest. Come to Simply Southwest for all your gifts and personal splurges, whether it be a Garrett Bradley bag, Brian Jewelry, or candle, to fit your room with your favorite set. We have it all at Simply Southwest.
Well, the first quarter play, the Beavers shot 41%. Or excuse me, Hutch Blue Dragon shot 41. The Beavers shot 37.5%. 9-1 in free throws. Points off a turnover. Had eight Hutch turnovers, or excuse me, 8 points off of turnovers. Pratt had 6 turnovers. And Hutch had 3, and Hutch has the ball as we start out the second quarter play, leading 19-13. Jada Jones steals the basketball, and they're going to get, and now Ortiz has it. She's going to get it. Finally got a control of things here, and the Beavers have the ball. Rhodey on the far side. Jones is looking to go underneath. Now Ortiz goes, and oh my goodness, a lot of contact. Nothing called again. Wow. 19-13. Blue Dragons lead it. Baxter gets the ball inside and gets it put up and in. Nice job by Brianna. Her first points of the afternoon. 4-point lead down. And Rhodey's going to get hand stuck in the cookie jar. But contact on the other end, no call, and a little reach-in foul on the other end, and that's a call, and now that's the second one on Rhodey. That's kind of unbelievable. Touch with the basketball, they inbound it. Staley with a 3, misses everything, and out of bounds it goes. Pratt will have the basketball back. Hey, Megan Poole came in at that break. They took Rhodey out with two fouls. I don't want to get her in a foul. Beavers with it. And Poole, again, 15-foot, 14-foot jumper, about 12-foot maybe. I'm not quite sure how it was, but anyway, she missed it. Inside, Staley down the far side. It goes to DeArmo. DeArmo back the far near side. DeArmo back again, tries to drive it down inside, throws it up against the glass, no good. But oh man, a lot of contact in there, nothing called, and Purser gets the easy bucket after three Beavers hit the floor. 21-15, Beavers down here to the Blue Dragons. Second quarter play, 22 left in the half. Schomburger, far side, there's Deuce with the 15-footer. It won't go in. And the Blue Dragons have it back. Nicole Taylor going to come in the ball game here at the next break. Oh, and how she got around them, she did, but Purser got around the baseline and had the easy bucket. And it's an 8-point lead, then Megan Poole running the floor gets the easy basket. 8 points for Megan Poole. Well, she runs the floor while she beat everybody down there. Nobody around there to protect it. Stately, the near side. Now they down inside to go again. The ball got slapped away. There's a three-point shot. No good. Baxter with the rebound again. And the Beavers have it. Near side. And no news to Poole. Poole got slapped on the arm and nothing called there. And there's Steph. Stephanie said, yeah. And Ortiz steals the basketball. Ortiz is going to have the open bucket and she's got it. Jasmine Ortiz with the steal and gets the Beavers back 23-19 here. So when Hutch decides to go on a run, Pratt kind of answers right back here. Mercer, near side to Rogers. Rogers trying to get baseline and they're going to call a foul. They're going to call it this way. They need to call it on both ends. They're going to call Baxter her second foul. Jada Jones is coming in along with Nicole Taylor. Terry comes in for the Blue Dragons, a 5'8 freshman out of Macon, Georgia. Inbounded to Madden, a sophomore from Topeka. Out of the near side. Bailey for three, and she got it. She's missed several lows, but back it goes. 26-19. Poole with the basketball. Megan gives it to Aubrey Newts. And there's Jada Jones for three. In and out, no good. Madden with the rebound. Beaver's got to watch out here and not let Hutch get on a big run. And we're going to get a foul call. That's an offensive foul. Mandy Madden gets called for the offensive foul. And a lot of booze behind us here, isn't it, Glenn? And now we're going to reverse the call. What? They reversed the call and now they say it's on Jada Jones. Unbelievable. Ooh. So I guess I'll mark that one foul off of that. Anyway, my goodness, yeah, very, very questionable. Williams, the short jumper, no good, offside rebounds goes to Jones, and she's going to bring it up. She'll run the point with Ortiz on the bench. Aubrey Noose, near side, there's Rhodey. Dominic takes her way inside. She gets mugged. Are they going to call? Oh, my word. Yep. A lot of contact going on. One end, and that's the way it is. Terry comes to the near side. DeGarmo, and another three-point shot, and it goes in. Taylor Stately, the last two down the floor have been three-pointers. A young lady out of Newton. And all of a sudden, Hutch jumps out to a 10-point lead. Schomburger dumps it inside. There's Rodas got it. And Dominic wants to go to the rack. She can get there. Beavers down by eight here. Williams, far side. To Terry. Terry with a floater, and it goes there. All of a sudden, Hutch is hitting everything. Long pass. Schomburger into the paint. Kicks it back out. Jada Jones for three. It won't go. Long rebound, and it's saved, but it goes to Hutchison. To the far side. Now down to the baseline. DeGarmo brings it back out front to Rogers. Now comes to the near side. They'll pass around the perimeter. They get to the far side at the wing. Now to the top of the key. 10 on the shot clock. And Broadus blacked that one from the backside, but it went off the rim. And Mandy Madden got lucky and hit her right in the nose, and she had an easy shot. Far side to Taylor. 33-21, Ortiz shoots the three, in and out, no good. Beavers haven't got a shot from outside the arc to go yet. Garmo brings it to the near side. Terry drives it inside again, and now a late whistle and another offensive foul. Terry, that's the second offensive charge that the Beavers have taken, and a timeout's called. And a full timeout on the floor, 33-21, 3:32 left in the half. The Blue Dragons lead it. We'll be back right after this timeout. You're listening to Beaver Basketball. Pratt has the basketball after the timeout. 33-21, Hutch leads. Megan Poole gives it back to Ortiz. Now they'll drop it down to Maddie Dusen, who came in at that break. Now back out front to Poole from the foul line, and she's got it. Megan Poole with 10. Makes it a 10-point ball game. Hutch with the lead, and they come to the near side. DeGarmo down inside to Williams, back out to DeGarmo, and DeGarmo's cut off before she can get inside. But Williams trying to drive it in. Megan Poole gets the block on that one, and now we'll go down the other end, and Jasmine Ortiz drives the paint. Again, a lot of contact, nothing made, but then Megan Poole picks up the loose ball and puts it in. Back to an 8-point ball game. Bring it up. Garmo to the far side at the elbow, directing traffic there, but she picked up her dribble and almost had a 5-count against her. Daly back to the far side to DeMarmo. Now to Rogers, 6 on the shot clock. Ball got knocked away. Williams had to shoot it. Comes off the glass hard. Here comes Pratt on a 3-on-1 break. A nice pass and a great assist from Megan Poole with another bucket. And John Altus wants a timeout. 1:54 left in the half, 33-27. That was a nice fast break, Glenn. That was operated beautifully, wasn't it? Megan Poole now had 6 in the first quarter, has 8 in this one. So she's been the nucleus that Pratt needed right now to stay in this ball game. That, and she's 6'2", and she's long. By long, I mean long arms, long legs. And she jumped pretty well. DeGarmo into the front court, comes to the near side to Stately. Back out front to Persner, now on the top of the key. Far side to DeGarmo, she gets cut off. Williams, 12 on the shot clock. 1:35 left in the half, and Hutch passing around the perimeter. Finally, they're going to take the 3-point shot. No good. And Megan Poole with the rebound. Nice rebound by Poole. She underneath. And now Poole goes up. Oh, my. Megan Poole got knocked. Oh, my goodness. Yep. Oh, well. 33-27, 1:16 left in the half. Hutch with the basketball. Garmo, far side it goes. Pressner now back out front. DeGarmo at the top of the key. Gives it to Staley, and she's going to pull up for a 15-footer, but she got fouled. Inside the 3-point line. And that one's going to be on Aubrey Noose. That's her second. Yep, she is. Haley knocks that one in. She's got 7 in this quarter. 2 of them were 3-pointers. She rolls that one off, no good. Pearson went to rebound, into the front court. Jasmine Ortiz goes over the top to Deuce, and Deuce on the far side, right at the paint, now brings it back. Jada Jones says she does the icky shuffle. 34-27, 47 seconds left in the half. It's been an interesting kind of ball game. First, neither team really, after the break, looked like they were that rusty, for sure. Persner. Back out to Williams. Now Williams is going to cut inside. Has to go over the top of Poole. And now late whistle again. Dixon with her third foul. Madden going to line to shoot 2. Knocked that first one in. Again, 63% shooter, averages 11 a game. Baxter comes back in the ball game for the Beavers.
Now, I had my head down and he said something.
35-27. 24 seconds left in the half. 36-27, and she makes both of them. And the Beavers need a bucket here to finish out the half. Down by 9. Far side, Baxter tries to go underneath the pool. Couldn't get it over the top. And all of a sudden, here comes Hutch. And, ooh, Jada Jones outran her, but got an arm instead of the ball. And they're going to call the foul on Jones. That's the second one on Jada. Rogers going to the line. She made 2 from there before. And that's off the iron, no good. And the second one is good. Williams just shoots 69%. She's averages 7 of a game. Ten-point ball game. 6.2 seconds left. Beavers down by 10. Jones, long pass. Ortiz is going to shoot the long three-pointer off the front iron, and that's the half. So at the end of the half, the Beavers down 37-27. Stick around. We'll have the halftime stats brought to you by Baker Professional Counting in Pratt. And more on our halftime show brought to you by the First National Bank in Pratt, where they're all working for you at the First National Bank. We'll be back in 2 minutes. You're listening to Beaver Basketball.
Thank you.
ended up in my lap. Hutch with the ball. Piercer, top of the key. There's a three-point shot. That's the first one she's missed. Young lady out of Newton. And again, ball gets slapped away. Boy, Beavers just can't hang on to the basketball right now, and Hutchison is just taking them apart. Yep. Gaeta Jones gets fouled. And that one is going to be on Madden. That's her second. And Jada Jones will go to the line. Jada out of Minneapolis, Minnesota. Missed the first two back in the first quarter. And misses that one. Usually a pretty good foul shooter, but